Yes, this is the one. This is a 2018 paper. Okay. This is the first foundation one paper. I think you have three. You have three, right? Three or four. Yeah, I have three foundation paper in 2008 June, and three higher paper as well. Okay, so we should do foundation papers right now, right? And then only you should go to higher paper, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so you have already done 2018 November foundation paper, I guess.
I think so. I'm not sure.
Okay, all right, no issues. Okay, dear. So we'll start with the first one. So you're not allowed to use a calculator. May not be used. And the time. Okay, so how much is the time limit? 1 hour 30 minutes. Okay, 1 hour 30 minutes. And you have how many questions? You have 25 questions. Okay. So basically, you get around 3.5 minutes for each question. Okay. So have that idea in the beginning itself and keep an eye on the watch as well. Okay. So you can't use more than 3.5 minutes for a single question. If you are using, make sure that you put a round mark and skip to the next question and come back to it once you finish the whole question paper. Okay, otherwise you will lose a lot of time on single question, which makes us hard to complete the thing. All right, okay, so starting from the first one. Oh, someone else is trying to join. Okay, it's actually one of the coordinators, but if a third person join after 40 minutes, the session will actually end. Okay, you might have to join once again. Is that okay with you?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, all right. So starting from the first question, are you able to read it?
Yeah, right, 3,000,
6,324 to nearest thousand. So what do you think? How should we do it?
it's 6,000.
Yes. So you have to see the number next to the thousands place number. So six in the thousand place, right? So you have to look at the number which comes next to it. So it is three. If the number which is coming to the next place or whatever they are asking is five or above five, then you need to round it to the next number. So six will become seven, 7,000 it will become. But if the number is less than six, it can be 4, 3, 2, 1, or zero, then you can round it to the lower value, 6,000. Okay. Now the second one. Write the following number in order of size. Start with the smallest number.
I think it should be minus six.
Yeah.
Okay, let me just. Then minus five. Then zero.
Yes.
Six and then 12.
Yes. So the thing about negative numbers and positive numbers is that in positive numbers, six is bigger than three. Okay,
Yeah.
but in negative numbers, minus six is smaller than minus three. Okay, that's how it goes. Because it's basically on the number line. So when you have from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, it goes backwards, it goes the other way around. Okay, now write the following numbers in order of size. So start with the smallest number.
So is it, I don't know if it's the number is bigger, does that mean it's smaller?
Not really. Again, just like comparing normally how you compare numbers, not the same way you have to do. So first look at the whole number part. Whole number is zero here, zero here, zero here, zero here. So they all are the same. Okay. Then look at the number after the decimal point. So first comes zero, seven, eight, seven. So which is the least?
Zero.
Yes. So that will be the smallest number. Okay.
Okay.
Now look at the remaining number. So this has seven, this also has seven. So now you need to check for the second place. So here you have eight, here you have zero. So which is smaller?
0.708.
Yes, so that will be the next one. Okay, what comes after that?
0.78.
Yes, and the last will be 0.87. Okay, it doesn't matter how many numbers you have the after decimal point. It doesn't matter. Okay, but the value of the numbers is what it matters. Okay, so after the decimal point, the first number is called as the 10th place.
Yeah.
Okay, 10th place because it is 1 by 10. Second number is called as the 100th place. The TH is coming after everything. 1 by 100. And 8 is in the 1000th place, which is 1 by thousands. Okay. All right. Now the next one. Write 20% as a fraction.
20 by 100.
Yes, 20 by 100. But whenever you are writing a fraction, you have to make sure that it is in the simplest form. So 20 by 100 can be written as?
4 by 20.
20 by 100. Yeah, tell me how. 4 by?
20.
20. Yes, good. Is that done?
4 by 10.
How?
1 by 10.
Oh, yeah. So, you're again dividing with 1 by? Dividing with 4, right?
Yeah, 1 by 4.
Yes, 1 by 5. There you go. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, the fourth one. Here is a list of 4 fractions. One of these fractions is not equivalent to 1 by 4. We have to find out that. So, basically, all the fractions should be converted to the simplest form.
Yeah.
So 4 by 16, when you cut it, what happens?
I think it's 15 by 60. No, sorry. 3 by 9.
Yes, 3 by 9. When you simplify, what do you get?
1 by 3.
Yes, it's 1 by 3. So your answer is 3 by 9. Correct. Very good. Now, write down the first even multiple of 7. So tell me the multiples of 7. Which are the multiples of 7?
1.
Multiples of any number starts with the number itself. So multiples of 7 starts with 7.
Oh, okay.
You are talking about factors, I guess. Yes, 7, 14, then?
Is that the first even multiple?
Yes, that's the first even multiple. But can you tell me 3 more after 14?
Even ones?
No. Just the normal multiples.
Oh, 21.
Yes.
28.
Yes.
35.
Yes, 35. So the first even multiple is 14. Okay. Now the next one.
Oh, this, I don't know how to do this one.
Algebraic expressions. They are called as expressions. They are called as expressions because they are a combination of numbers and variables. Okay, so variables are the alphabets. You can use any alphabet from the 26. And numbers are called as the constants. Okay, so when you have such things, what you have to do is, it's pure multiplication. There is nothing else. So you have to multiply the numbers first. What is 3 into 4?
12.
Yes. So it is 12t. That's it. Just multiply the numbers and write the variables with it because it was multiplication. Okay. But when addition and subtraction happens, what you have to do is that you have to identify the like terms. Okay. Like terms are those terms which have the same variables with them. So if I write 2x minus 3y plus 5x. Okay. Can you tell me which are the variable, which are the terms which have the same variable in them? Sorry?
2x and 5x.
Yes, 2x and 5x. So I can do them. 2x and 5x. If you add them, I get 7x.
Yeah.
And minus 3y doesn't have any partner there. So you have to write it as minus 3y itself. Okay.
How do you know? Because minus 7 plus is...
No. It's because x and y. 7 has x along with him. 3 has y along with. So you can't combine them.
How do you know that you had to add 2x and 5x.
There you go. There is an addition sign here.
Oh, okay.
2x plus 5x. If it was minus, it would have been 2x minus 5x, which is minus 3x. Okay?